What's up, everybody, and welcome to another episode of No Rules, Just Real. I hope you all had a great week. I myself had a pretty busy week, so I'm going to tell you about some cool things that I got to do. I had a one-on-one with my acting coach and mentor, Reno Venturi. He took time out of his very, very busy schedule to meet with me one-on-one and go over some things that he thinks I need to work on to kind of take me to the next level as an actor. And all the things that he kind of told me, you never really realize that you're doing until somebody kind of calls you out on it. And then you're like, oh my God, that's exactly what I've been doing. So apparently what I need to work on, and I will work on, is being less caring about what I think people are going to think of me in a scene or when they view something. I feel like right now I think that a lot of the attention is on me and a lot of eyes are watching me to see kind of what I'm going to be doing. And I am so aware of that, and I need to be less of a perfectionist and just, you know, feel the character and feel the moment and just live in that moment. So that's something that I'm going to be working on, and I have been working on ever since that one-on-one and will continue to work on. So thank you so much, Reno, for taking the time out to help a fellow actor. So I did that last week. Also, I worked at both Foxwoods and Mohegan this weekend hosting different events. At Mohegan Sun, I hosted Bingo After Dark, which the tagline for that is not your grandmother's average bingo, and it really is not. There is a DJ and music and dancing and people drinking, so it's more like a wedding than an actual bingo. So that was so fun to do that. They have that every 3 months or so at the casino, so make sure you guys look out for the next one. I actually just got booked to host Beer Fest again at Mohegan Sun, so I'm going to be doing that in October. So if you guys like drinking beer and you only want to pay $20 for all you can drink and try all different beers from all over the place, sign up for that. It's going to be a good time. On Monday, I got to be on set of Silence the Film, which, thank you so much, Carlin Fournier, my homie, my girl. I love you so much. She really is been such a great supporter for me in this New England acting community. And she always looks out for her people and is always looking out for castings and different things. So she's actually a producer on Silence the Film. And she invited me to be in a scene. And I had the immense honor of being on set and working with Nelson Reese, who is the director on the film. I've never worked with him before, and if you guys haven't heard of him or worked with him before, I highly recommend you looking him up, because the dude is a genius. Just watching him kind of fly around set, he has so much vision and so much passion, and he was like head first diving into each scene with the actors. And even at one point, he was kind of holding the camera, the handheld camera, and he was in the mix and kind of pushing the actor and pulling the actor to get this one look and feel for the scene. So amazing, amazing honor to work with Nelson Reese, and I can't wait for that film to come out. So make sure you guys look out for Silence, the film. I also had a really cool experience on set, and I met some cool people that I haven't worked with before, and I also got to reconnect with some of the people that I have worked with and gone to workshops with. So that was a really cool experience. On Tuesday, I was invited to the Peter Pino radio show to promote Cape Crusader, The Dark Hours. I was there with some of my cast and crew members. So that was a really, really rewarding experience. I never have done a live radio interview before, so that was kind of cool to be there and see kind of the behind the scenes of the radio and actually be there as it's being live streamed on the internet and have people call in and ask questions. So that was really cool. So thank you, Peter, and thank you to my entire Cape Crusader cast and crew that was there with me. I had a really fun night. So what I want to talk to you guys about today, and hopefully we won't make this too long of a video, but one of my friends in the community wrote me a quick Facebook inbox and asked me a question. She noticed that, for the last couple months I've been doing the full-time entertainment work, And this is something that she wants to get involved more in, but she has a 9 to 5 right now that pays substantial and she's making a decent living in, but she is finding that it's kind of holding her back from, becoming more involved in the acting community because she can't take time off to go to auditions or go to gigs, or when she does do that, her job is kind of, a little strict on that, which is the very same situation that I was in at one point in time. You want to go to all the gigs and castings and auditions that you can, but the more time that you take off from work, the more strain you kind of get from, your supervisors and stuff like that. But also, if you're not booking a lot of work and you're not getting a lot ton of money from doing background work and smaller gigs, then it's hard to make the jump to become a full-time actor because you're nervous about what you're gonna do to pay bills or can I leave all that money? So what I want to do is open this up to everybody in the New England acting community, and you know what? Let's open it up to the entire acting community. If you're watching this video and you have some tips and tricks on what is the best way or what you did to become a full-time actor, let's just get these comments going and let's start brainstorming and helping one each other, one another out. What I told her I did is I had to kind of diversify my background a little bit. I couldn't just focus solely on acting right now. One day I hopefully will, but for the time being, I'm doing modeling gigs, I'm doing hosting gigs, focusing on acting, but not just in features. I'm doing commercials, music videos, kind of anything I can sink my teeth into to make ends meet and to get a check so that I'm not feeling that strain of, worrying about the next gig and the next gig because it is something that is kind of scary, especially when you're not getting that 9 to 5 weekly or bi-weekly paycheck that you can kind of rely on. So let's go, acting community. Let's start getting those tips and tricks and helping one another out and, brainstorming on the best way to convert over to a full-time entertainer or what you guys recommend. Hopefully we have a good conversation and I will see you guys next week on another episode of No Rules, Just Real. Thank you so much.